the Star Wars fans and our FlyGuy.net review of The Phandumb Menace 3D, which I went to see in cinemas a couple of nights ago. Haven't had a chance to review it, but FlyGirl and I went to see it, one of the late night showings, and thought I'd give you a bit of a review here if you haven't had a chance to see it. Now, first of all, if you don't like The Phandumb Menace, don't be hating if I give you something you don't like about the movie. It's just my own personal review. Very short and brief, just give you a couple of pluses and negatives I thought about the movie. Look, it has to be said, it's great to get Star Wars back into the cinema again. It's really great to see Star Wars up in the big screen, and nothing beats seeing the big Star Wars logo and the sound booming out. It's great. Wonderful to have Star Wars back in the movie theatre, so loving that. It's a real big plus to get to see Star Wars again. New toys in store, all the promotion that's been around, Hasbro, the stores with new toys. I've got a pile of stuff I've got to review here. Some of the new Phantom Menace vintage collection and other stuff. It's brilliant to see this in stores, and it's great that Hasbro have been doing this with Lucasfilm and the movie. Excellent. Another real plus for getting the movie back out. Liam Neeson continues to be, I think, the best thing in the movie. One of the strongest actors. He just brings such a dominance to the screen. Ewan McGregor at times definitely does, but ultimately he's the real strong one, I think, Liam Neeson in the movie. So again, he's a great actor, and I think he really works well in the movie, and he's the movie's strongest point. Just looking at some other notes I've made here, the digital Yoda. It's finally great to get rid of that really poor puppet that was in the movie. Hence they replaced it obviously for Star Wars in concert, and now for The Phantom Menace in 3D. It's a great improvement and really brings it into line with all the other Yodas that you've seen in Attack of Clones and of course in Revenge of the Sith. So that's another plus point. The pod racing, look, pod racing in 3D, huge big screen, awesome sound, cleaned up and looking refreshed. It's pretty awesome. The pod racing is probably the highlight of the movie, and really it's what you'll see, obviously the key thing in the posters. Pod racing looks great. The sound's awesome. It's just, you know, you're really in there, and it's a really great kind of sequence. The mall battle with Obi-Wan and Qui-Gon, like, it's still awesome, it's still great. Maul is brilliant in the movie. For these all too brief scenes, he's just there too little. There's not enough on this bad guy, and he says about three words. It's just, it's not quite right. Anyway, great sequence, we all know it if you've seen the movie, and great parts to it, but it's just that part of the movie. Which leaves with some of the other negative sides that I think on the movie. Look, 3D was all the hype here. What 3D? There really is no 3D in this movie. It's 3D-less. We really struggled, and we asked a couple of fans and other people outside what they thought of the movie. Everybody thought the same. What 3D? That there was just so little 3D done. Now, we're not expecting Lucasfilm to suddenly change the movie and if things deliberately changing the movie to fly out and come in your face, but it was nothing. It was just such a minimal variation that's done in the movie, so really not great. It didn't make much of a difference to the movie, quite frankly. I would have been happily watching it in 2D and felt as if the entire movie was in 2D, so not great. 3D's not a big feature. I'll just say his name and say no more. Jar Jar Binks. Can't say any more. Really sorry, guys. I won't see anymore. Look, there's some really epic wooden acting in this movie. It's terrible at times. But let's not blame the actors. They were doing basically green screen, acting against a tennis ball and a puppet of Yoda. Wasn't great. Some of the acting's pretty shoddy. Maybe hasn't stood the test of time. Just doesn't seem quite right. There's a lot of flaws in this movie. More so than I would say the original trilogy movies, but that's just my opinion again, so don't be hating Phantom Menace lovers. And probably the biggest thing about this that I really thought was a negative was the price. This is one incredibly overpriced movie. Remember, it's a 10-year-old movie. This should be way cheaper than it is. $26 it costs here in Australia to see this 3D movie. That's extortionate. Now, it costs about 16 or 17 British pounds to see it, which is roughly exactly the same as $26. You guys in the US continue to get prices a little bit cheaper. It's round about $15, $16 as far as I see from some of the theatres that I've been to, looking up on their websites. So, this is one very, very expensive movie. Some nice features, though, in the US, a couple of places had some excellent Real-D 3D movie glasses. That's a nice touch. But nowhere else did I see anything really too fantastic about it. We went to one of the midnight showings. It was a massive cinema, awesome sound, huge 3D. There wasn't that many of us. It was pretty damn quiet. So, let us know what you think. Leave a comment below and let us know. I'm finally catching up in comments, but I'd love to know what you think of this movie. Good, bad, let's not get into the guts of the Phantom Menace itself too much. These are just my opinions, but let us know what you think, whether you, the best parts of the movie for you, the worst parts of the movie for you, and prices. Let us know how much you're charging in your countries, particularly some of you guys not in the UK, in the US and Australia. What about you guys in Europe? Japan, China, Italy, what are you getting charged? We'd love to know how much this this movie's going for, because it's way more expensive than buying a Blu-ray and a DVD, so it just seems a little bit overpriced to me. In fact, a lot overpriced. Anyway, hope you didn't mind that it wasn't a review of a figure, but stay tuned. We've got a pile of Phantom Menace figures to come up for you. Just got a whole host of stuff we just got delivered. So hang around and hit the subscribe button there, and you'll get loads more reviews on your way. Cheers.